Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Marypetrushko. I upload weekly videos here on my channel along with a monthly giveaway video. So for today's video, I'm going to be continuing my declutter series. I have blushes, bronzers, and highlighters for this video. I do want to point out that when I was filming the declutter portion, I think I kind of messed something up with the lighting or whatnot. So the lighting looks kind of off in the declutter portion. So I'm sorry about that. But if you guys are interested in seeing what products I kept and what I get rid of, then just keep watching. Okay guys, we're going to start off with this drawer. It is my bronzer and my blush drawer. I'm also going to be inserting little swatch clips of everything so you can just see how it all looks. But let's start with the bronzers. First I have from Buxom. This is their Staycation Vibes Backyard Bronzer. I'm going to be keeping this. This is really nice. The formula is beautiful. The packaging is really like heavy duty and luxurious. I am also keeping this from Milani. It is their Silky Matte in the shade Sun Kiss. This is just a classic. I feel like it's a staple. Almost everybody that I follow here on YouTube has this and recommends it. Also keeping this from Well People. This is in the shade Golden Hour. This is a really pretty like shimmery bronzer, and I like to also wear this all over my lid or just in my crease, so I'm going to be keeping this. I'm going to be getting rid of this Believe Beauty. This brand, I believe, is exclusively at Dollar General. I did just do a whole like full face of this brand, so I can link that down below. But it is really pretty. It has like this nice marbled effect. It's gorgeous, actually. I don't use it enough to keep it, so I am going to be getting rid of this one. This is from Wet n Wild. It's a contour stick in the shade Where's Walnut. I absolutely love this, and I love cream products, especially in the summer, so I'm going to keep this. Also keeping this from Nabla is their Skin Glazing in the shade Amber. I just got this. You can see like it's pretty new, but it is so beautiful. I love every single Nabla product that I have. Definitely recommend this. I think it's gorgeous. This one is from Item Beauty. I got this in an Ipsy bag. I don't even know how long ago. It's got like a swipe and glow, so it's got two different things. I believe it's Addison Rae's brand. I just have not used this. I don't think ever except once, so I'm going to get rid of this. Not worth it for me to keep. I have a classic, the Butter Bronzer. I have this in, I believe, Deep Bronzer. This is, I mean, I don't think anybody could ever get rid of this if you have it. It's a classic. It's a staple. I use it all the time. Absolutely love it. This is an e.l.f. Bronzer Forever Sunkissed. This is good. I really like it. The quality is nice for drugstore, so I am going to keep this. I want to do like a full face of e.l.f. sometime soon, so I'm going to hold on to that. I am going to get rid of this, however. It is the Becca Sunlit Bronzer in Bronze Bondi. Becca like went out of business, so you can't find them anymore. But this is really pretty. It's gorgeous, actually. This is like my perfect summer bronzer. I just have not used it in a long, long time, so I am going to get rid of this one. I've got these two cream bronzers. I have one from Yinsa and one from e.l.f. The one in e.l.f. is called Honey Drip, and the Yinsa one is called Sunlit Glow. These are both gorgeous. I do have different undertones. I'm going to be keeping both, and I'm going to put their swatches next to each other. So on the left, you're going to have the Yinsa, and on the right, you're going to have the e.l.f. They're both gorgeous, super creamy, so definitely going to be keeping both of those. Next, we have two palettes. So this is from Complex Culture. It's like a bronzer and a blush. I honestly don't think I've ever used this except maybe once. I got this in a subscription box as well, so I am going to be passing that along. But I am going to be keeping my Smashbox Cali Contour Palette. I absolutely love this, especially for traveling, because you have, you know, bronzer, contour, two highlighters, an under eye powder, and a really pretty blush. This is just absolutely perfect. Definitely keeping that. Okay, so for my bronzers, I am keeping 9 and 1 palette, and then I am decluttering 3 bronzers and 1 palette. So that's actually pretty good. Let's move on to blushes here. So first up, I have from Hourglass. This is their Ambient Lights, I guess, and this is an incandescent electric.
Spectra. This is really pretty. It's a really light shade though, kind of like shimmery too, but I do really like it. So I am going to be keeping this one. This is from Essence. It is the blush. I have two of these, I believe. The other one right here, this is Beloved and this is Bespoke. I will swatch them both next to each other. I'm going to keep the pinkier one and declutter this more kind of like bronzy shade, just because I have this one from Alme and I think it is pretty similar to it and I like the Alme one better. So keeping this one, and this is in the shade Nearly Nude. I'm going to put them both together so you can see they are pretty similar. I just like the Alme one better, so I'm keeping that one. I have this e.l.f. Putty Blush in the shade Tahiti. I do like this. I'm going to be keeping it. I am a sucker for any cream products. They're like my favorite. This one from ColourPop, I think I will get rid of. It's from like their Limoncello launch, I think. I'm not sure. It's in the shade Cottage Life. I don't even really think I've used this, honestly. Maybe once, so I can get rid of this one. I have two from Ofra. I have Rose right here, and then I have Bellini right here. These are really pretty. I love this formula. So I am definitely going to be keeping both of these. Keeping both of these as well. This one right here is Dolly and this is Seychelles. These are just gorgeous. I love the Buxom formula. I want to try more from them. So definitely keeping both of those. Let's see. Next we have from e.l.f. This is the shade Always Rosy. I do really like this. Again, I want to do like a full face of e.l.f. eventually. So I'm going to keep this for that video. From Persona Cosmetics, I have the shade Georgia. Definitely keeping this. Y'all, I'm probably hardly going to be getting rid of any blush, honestly. Okay, this one is Milani. It's their Cheek Kiss in the shade Nude Kiss. This is really pretty as well. Again, cream blushes are my jam. I have a bunch of ColourPop ones. First up is Birthday Suit. This is like a really pretty pinky shade. I really like this one. Just gonna let you guys know I'm keeping every single one of these ColourPop ones. These next three are from their wine, like their Wine Knot collection. This one is Cruel Intentions. These are so pretty and so creamy. This one, Brute Flute, is my absolute favorite, as you can tell. I went a little crazy with it. I think this is honestly like my all-time favorite blush out of all of them, out of all of my blushes. And then this one is really pretty. It's called Cheerio. This one I try to use in the winter because it's a lot more of like a deep berry shade, but I do really love it. I think it is gorgeous. This I will get rid of. It is from Believe Beauty and it is in the shade Doll Face. This is really pretty. However, I felt like it like faded really quick on my skin, so I'm not gonna keep that one. Next, I have this Milk Makeup one in the shade Work. I absolutely love this. This is gorgeous because it's really nice because you can use it on your cheeks and your lips. It's like a multi-purpose type of thing. So keeping that one. Also keeping this from Nabla. It's their Skin Glazing in Truth. Ugh, so pretty. It's like a nice kind of like shimmery, highlighty blush. You could probably even use it as a highlight if you want, or a blush topper. Really love it. Let's see, Milani Luminoso, definitely not getting rid of this. This is a classic. Absolutely love this. So pretty. Okay, last we have a bunch of palettes. This is from Alamar Cosmetics. I'm not really a huge palette person, but I do really love this. All the shades on here are absolutely gorgeous. So I'm going to be keeping that one. Also keeping this Lorac one, the Shine Bright one. This is so incredibly pretty. I absolutely love it. This highlighter, gorgeous. So amazing. I don't know if you can get this anymore, but if you can ever find it, definitely pick it up. I am going to get rid of this. This is from The Balm. It's this Girl Powder blush palette. It's really pretty. It is super powdery, though. I just haven't really used it, so I can feel good with just passing that along. Same for this one. This is Real Her Ultimate Glow Getter, a cheek trio right here. Again, I don't ever think I've used this. It would be really nice for traveling though, because you have a bronzer, a highlight, and a blush. It is super pretty. I just do not use it, so I'm gonna get rid of it. And then I am also keeping this one. I don't think I could ever get rid of this. It's Natasha Denona. Hello. But it is super gorgeous. Look at that. So incredibly pretty. I love how the creams have like this little spot right here so it can't, you know, mess up or anything. So I'm definitely going to be keeping this one as well. Okay, so for blushes, I am keeping 16 in 3 palettes, and I am decluttering 3 blushes and 2 palettes. So now we are going to go ahead and hop into the last part of this, which is going to be my highlight drawer. Okay, so this is the last part, and it is my highlight drawer. I really honestly don't feel like I'm going to get rid of much just because I absolutely love my highlights. Let's go ahead and kick it off with this. This is from Believe Beauty. It's really pretty. However, I just do not use it. So I'm going to get rid of this one. It is a good dupe for this one from Milk. Like, they look really similar, honestly. But I just like the Milk one better. And this swatch comparison that I'm going to show you, I'm going to swatch them both together. And I'm going to put the Believe one on the left and the Milk one on the right, just so you can see them side by side. But I'm going to keep the Milk one, and I'm going to declutter the Believe Beauty. Next, we have from Flesh. This is their little highlighter stick in the shade Pinky. I like this because it's like a little mini size, and it's this really pretty pink color. So I'm going to keep this one. I am keeping every single one of my Super Shock shades. And the swatch part, they're all going to be listed in order that I'm going to be telling you them. So first up is Flexitarian. This is probably my favorite. Next we have Seismic. It's more of like a glittery one, so it can be a little bit intense. And then Lunch Money is the last one, and this one is more of the subtle one, but you can build it up to a really pretty glow. Definitely keeping all three of those. This one is from OMFG Cosmetics and their shade Vanilla Birthday Cake. This is so pretty and it smells so good. However, mine is broken and my son did dig his fingernail into it and he actually ate some of it, but that was like a year ago and I don't think I've used it since. But I do have a coupon code with them. It is MaryP, so you can use that to save some coin if you want. I am, however, going to declutter this one even though it smells so good, but I am actually probably going to pick up something else from their site just because I don't like having broken things. It really like ticks me off, so I am going to get rid of this one. Next, we have this one from ABH. This is their Liquid Glow in the shade Perla. This is stunning. I absolutely love this, especially in the summer. So I'm going to keep that one. Kvoss highlighter? I honestly don't even know what this looks like. Oh, okay. I don't think I've ever used this. So I'm probably going to get rid of this, honestly. So pass that one along. Let's see. Next, we have this Flower Beauty one. I absolutely love this. I think it's gorgeous. I hit pan over here. Love, love, love. Definitely keeping this. It came with a brush, but the brush was crap, so I just tossed it. Next is from NYX. This is their High Gloss in the shade Moonbeam. This is really cool. It's got like a really nice putty type texture. Not quite like a Super Shock from ColourPop, but it's pretty close. However, I just don't use this, so I'm going to pass this one along as well. I have 2 from Nabla. These are probably my favorite highlighters. You can just see this one, how much I've used it. This one is Ozone here first, and then this one is Privilege. These are both so beautiful, so I'm gonna be keeping both of those. Next, we have this from The Beauty Crop. I don't even know when I've used this last, so I'm actually gonna go ahead and just get rid of this one. Next, I have from Wet n Wild, and it is their I'm So Lit Loose powder. This is gorgeous. It's actually blinding. However, it's super messy and it's huge. I just don't use it, so I'm gonna pass this along.
Next I have from Pretty Vulgar. This is their Shimmering Swan. This is gorgeous. I used to use this all the time. So I am definitely going to be keeping this one. Essence Pure Nude. This is a classic. It's a really pretty subtle type of highlight that you can build up a little bit, but I think this is gorgeous, especially for like an everyday type of thing or just a little bit of light makeup. So I'm definitely keeping that. Also keeping from Buxom, this is their White Russian. This is new too. I just think it is so gorgeous. If you have noticed, I have Buxom bronzer, blushes, and highlights. I just love the formula, so I'm definitely keeping this one. This is the only shade I think they have in highlight. I wish they would come out with more because I love the formula. I've got two more from ColourPop. This is their Villains collection. This is the Hades, Everybody's Got a Weakness. I absolutely love this. I lost a chunk here. Don't know where that went. Probably what I found on my carpet earlier, honestly. But I'm keeping this. Absolutely love it. Another one is Horse and Carriage. I think this was limited edition. I don't know if you can get it anymore, but it is gorgeous. It's blinding. So keeping this. I will be getting rid of this Glodient makeup palette. It's gorgeous, absolutely beautiful. You can use each one individually or you can like use it all together. Super pretty, I just do not use it. So I'm gonna get rid of this one. Next we have from Kylie Cosmetics. This is the Cheers Darling. I just recently got this. I haven't used it yet, so I'm gonna keep this one actually. Next we have two from Fenty. This one is the Duo One, Girl Next Door, and Chic Freak. I first of all love the packaging on this. I think it's so cool, but this is so pretty, these pinky shades. I absolutely love it. So I'm keeping this one, and I'm keeping this one, Hustla Baby. This one is really pretty too. Ugh. So pretty. I love it. Keeping. And then the last one, shocker, I am also keeping. It is Ofra and Nikki Tutorials Glazed Donut. I mean, look at that. Come on. It is gorgeous. Okay, so for highlights, I am keeping 17 in one palette. And then I am getting rid of 5 highlighters and 2 palettes. So that's a pretty good little chunk of stuff I am getting rid of there.
And here's all of the blush, bronzer, and highlighters that I am getting rid of.
Alright guys, that's all I have for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you guys on my next video. Bye!